Hey, today I'm going to take a look at the attenuating side of the Universal Audio OX. That box does a lot of stuff, one thing I haven't really touched on at all is the attenuator side. Mostly because in the studio, it's don't attenuate. You know, you'll just turn it up to a million and it's off amps in another room. It doesn't really matter so much. But, you know, some people have asked for it, and I'm kind of curious myself. So we're talking about real live speaker, just reducing that volume. And you'll use this most often with non-master volume amps. In this case, I used my 60s Blackface Bassman head, which is 50 watts. And, you know, right around 3, it's as loud as it's going to get. It's loud. I ran that through a 112, and I was going to put the 112 in here and really see, like, I'll just do it in here. It's so loud, my ears were ringing. It is balls loud. Just ridiculous. So I did put the cab back in the ISO, and I ran it there. And then I also did a test using a master volume amp, my Marshall Silver Jubilee. What was interesting is that the OX behaved quite differently with the Fender and then with the Marshall. So please watch them both, okay? Because they're very different. I want to show you how I did this test. So let's take a look at the waveforms here. The first go round is full unattenuated. And then each consecutive waveform is one notch down on the OX's attenuator. And it's not a smooth attenuation. It's like click, click. Those are straight settings. So, I mean, if you're like, it's close, I just would like to adjust my volume a little bit, you're kind of out of luck. It's a drastic change on some of them. For the first go around, I'm going to just show you a shorter clip so you can hear how the volume will change. And I'll show you in decibels basically how far that's adjusting sort of in the real world coming out of the speaker. And then the important part is when I do a volume compensation. So even though the volume coming out of the speaker is significantly lower, in software, in the computer, I'll raise it back up. So they're all evenly leveled. And so you could actually hear what the sound difference is. There's a lot of things that'll contribute to that. One of them is sound pressure and the way it hits the microphone, the speaker, and the way the cabinet, the air comes out of the cabinet, you know, at high volumes, there's so much pressure, it's like a laser beam coming out. And then when you're quiet, you could actually sort of hear the depth of the cabinet a lot better. And that those things change depending on the volume. But the OX also has certain character in there. One thing I noticed as you get kind of in the lower settings of the OX where you're really pulling the volume down is it has sort of a EQ curve happening also, which I assume is intentional. It's something like this, to where the bottom end comes up, the top end comes down, there's a little presence. And you know, you may say like, well, this is not transparent, what's happening? Well, it did sound kind of transparent with the Fender, but you did still hear that bottom end lift. And if you're sitting in front of the amp, and you're probably using one of those really low settings to sit in front of the amp and play at home or something like that, it's kind of what I'd want. I want that extra bottom end, and I want to take off some of that like top end, like ouch pressure. So you know, for me, that's kind of a little sweet little thing. It would be nice if you could turn it on and off maybe, but that is a mechanical thing. That's not a software thing. So that's the choice they made. And you'll be able to hear it pretty easily, I think, on the Marshall side of things. So anyway, without further ado, here they are.
So to me, that test is, that's pretty amazing. I mean, there's very little tonal change considering there's a 35 dB drop in volume. I'm really surprised that they're so similar with such a different sound pressure level coming out of the speaker. Color me impressed. Now check out, it does behave differently with the Marshall. So check this out. So there's definitely some filtering going on that you could hear on positions 3, 2, and 1. To be quite honest, like, you get a lot of volume attenuation on position 3, and that filter, I like the sound of it. And if I was to dial in the amp with the attenuation filter happening, I think I'll get a better sound than I would have even with the master volume. And speaking of the master volume, so just as a little foil to this, I did the same thing, really loud, which is volume on like 8 master volume, which is crazy loud. And then I lowered it to the master volume on the amp to where the 3 position was. And then I lowered it to where the 2 position was. Again, just turning the master volume down. And I was kind of surprised. The tone stayed the same. I had always kind of poo-pooed the master volume on the this amp, so but it kind of stayed the same, so maybe I have to rethink some things. Anyway, thanks for watching, especially if you're still around for back here. See you. Sorry for the blurry camera, and sorry that my fly was open for most of the video.